set it down. Well?
The drug worked as you said it would. They are completely under our control.
You mean my control? These three men will form the nucleus of the most deadly group of assassins the world has ever known. Three of the deadliest men in the world, programmed to kill on my command. Death machines. I've worked years for this, and these men must be perfect.
They are.
So you say. Before I put them into action, I think you should run them through another set of experimental tests. That man and his people will be a good test. He's part of an old and obsolete organization.
It will be done.
And so it shall be.
Yeah, George. This is Mr. G. Listen, I got two jobs for you. Same price. Number one, a Chinese gentleman by the name of Ho Lung runs a karate studio in your city. Number two, Nathan Adams. Right, the bank VP. I want them both hit by next week. So put your best man on it. Let me know when it's done. Right. Fell off a building. Accident? Accident my ass. Hey, business. What about Adams? Well, get someone else to take care of him then. And after that, see if he hit home run. And this time without screwing up, huh? Hey! Get your ass back in bed! Yeah? Blowing up? Blowing up? What do you mean, blowing up?
If this continues and the boys back east get rid of it, I'm out of business. Or worse,
I should have known you couldn't handle this. Who's doing it?
Well, how am I supposed to know, goddammit?
What do you mean you don't know?
Look, whoever's hitting my boys has probably got my line tapped. You know what I mean? Yeah. Well, I'm calling from a phone booth now.
Well, you better find out who's doing it and take care of it.
Well, how am I supposed to take care of it? I don't know what's going on. Now, look, Mr. G, I've got to have some more time and some help, too. They're trying to take this town and shove it up my ass.
Contract killings in this city are under my control. If you want someone killed, I'm afraid you'll have to deal with me.
Deal with you? Look, I don't have to deal with anyone.
If you want someone killed in this city, you must deal with us in person, and we will discuss the fee.
What is it?
Don't you want me to go in there with you?
What for? I can handle this alone. Go eat dinner at Tony's. I'll call you there when I need you.
But you shouldn't go in there without protection. I mean, why take chances with those people?
Look, I only hired you because of your father. So don't start telling me what to do. Don't say shit to me. Just drive the car and do what I say. Do you understand?
Yes, sir.
And you better be there when I call. And not out screwing around like you did last time. You hear?
Yes, sir.
Hey,
Please, wait here.
So good of you to come, Mr. Giolitti.
Oh, don't mention it.
Are you ready to avail yourself of my success?
Let's just say I don't intend losing any more of my men.
Please accept my expression of sympathy for the death of your employees.
They were good men, highly professional.
I think you will find my organization also highly professional.
Well, before I tell you who I want hit, before I spend any of my money, I'd like to see just how professional you really are.
I shall gladly give you a demonstration after dinner.
Here you are, Mike. I don't care what anybody says. You no get a spaghetti this good and nowhere back east. I told the boys to fix it up an extra special for good friend.
You're the best, Tony.
Yeah, that's right. And wait till you taste the sauce. It's a special too. It's my own recipe. Lots of people, they're asking me for the recipe, but I'm going to tell them nothing of doing. Hey, Mike, why should I tell them, huh? So they can open up at their own restaurant? Or maybe they eat at home? No. You want to taste the food like this? You got to come and see Tony. Now, you need anything, Mike, you just call me, huh?
All right, Tony, thank you. It looks great.
Hey, taste the good, too. Go on, try it. Hey, you see what I say? Okay, I'll let you eat now, huh?
Okay. Hey, Tony, come here.
It's a good, no?
No, what do you call this, a joke?
It's a no joke. Are you finding the spaghetti? I fire the one who did this, even if it's my own brother.
You're liking, Mr. Violetti?
It's all right, but let's get down to business.
Without the demonstration you asked for?
Yeah, later. If we can come to a business agreement, I want these two men here.
Oh, yes, Mr. Lang. He uses his karate studio as a front for narcotics traffic.
You're well informed. The other man, Nathan Adams, he keeps forgetting he's supposed to be working for me.
Kill him, and he is replaced by another one of your men at the bank.
I just want him out.
Now, what about that demonstration?
We must keep things even. Now, shall we do business?
All right.
That this man receives one of our red Buddhas. I believe you can find him at his karate school tonight. Oh, and please don't leave any witnesses.
Does this Buddha belong to anyone? It was left outside of my office. Perhaps I'll keep it then.
Thank you. Hey, wait a minute. I know him. What happened?
Got his hand cut off. He's in shock.
Jesus.
Shut up and go quit talking to
him. You all right?
Anything you intend to call him
there, I'll talk to him later.
Clay? Thank you, Mike.
God, I hate coming back here.
Beats being on the streets.
You'll change your mind in a couple of weeks.
Well, if it isn't Lieutenant Foster. Glad to see you could join us.
Don't start on me. We've been out on this case till 3 a.m. this morning.
All right, tell me, where's this Frank Thomas? What room are they keeping him in?
Why do you want to know? Our case.
Well, you guys have been ticketed for that human relations class. That's what the captain said.
We'll handle that. You stay out of our case.
Okay, it's your funeral.
Who's right? Here's a memo from the captain.
Oh, screw that human relations crap.
You're supposed to show up for a makeup today, and I'm supposed to go with you.
Forrester, homicide. Fine, we'll be right out.
Hospital?
Frank is conscious. We can talk to him.
Hey, what about this?
What do you want to be, a detective or a paper pusher?
Let's go.
I think we better check out that human relations class.
Don't worry about it, Jerry. Lieutenant Forrester, Frank Thomas's room.
Room 376 down the hall.
Thank you.
I hate hospitals.
You better get used to them. You spend a lot of time in hospitals questioning people.
I don't think I'll ever get used to it.
Hi, Lieutenant.
Were there any visitors?
Nobody, just the hospital staff.
Keep your eyes open.
Right.
Frank?
I'm awake.
Clay Forrester. My partner, Jerry Farnham.
What are you guys doing here? Questions?
You up to it?
Sure.
Frank, you ever seen this before?
Mr. Lung, our instructor, found it somewhere. I don't know where.
I've only got one question. Could you identify them if you saw them again?
I'll never forget their faces. If you don't find them, Forrester, I will.
You leave the police work to me.
Who's talking about police work? If I find them first, I'll send them to you in pieces.
You're not going anywhere for a while. I'll stop in later with the sketch artist to draw up those faces before you forget them.
Lieutenant, I won't be forgetting them.
Good. We'll be seeing you.
Take care of yourself, Frank.
Fun job, I bet.
Nurse is the only thing keeping me awake.
Well, at least you're inside.
Yeah. See ya.
Oh, Lieutenant. About those security rules, can the patient receive gifts?
Like what?
Well, this package was left for him downstairs. There was no card on it, just his name on the box.
Let's have a look at it.
thought I was clear when I told you to leave no witnesses. I just delivered a Buddha to the hospital. The witness is on the third floor. I suggest you finish the job tonight before he tells the police too much.
I didn't mean to wake you.
Oh, if it isn't Florence Nightingale again. You come to see if my tubes are all in place?
At least the insults are getting a little tamer. You should have heard yourself when you were under sedation.
Say, when are they going to take this junk off anyway?
That's up to Dr. Putnam. Maybe in a week.
Well, I'll tell you one thing. I'm not going to let Putnam put a goddamn hook on me.
Well, that may not even be necessary. They have cosmetic hands now.
Oh, that's a great choice, isn't it? A useless decoration or something that turns me into a freak show?
Look, I know how tough it is being in a hospital and not having a family.
Well, I've been on my own for a long time now and everything is just okay.
Everyone needs friends. We all do.
The only thing I need right now is my right hand. Say, what are you? A nurse or a psychiatrist?
Just call me Florence.
Killed or captured at the hospital tonight.
And the witness?
They say he is dead.
How was our man captured?
They really don't know. There were shots. They barely escaped. They thought he was behind them when they fled.
Fled?
It's an old trick.
Yeah, but your idea worked, Clay.
It's the next time I'm worried about.
Especially with those armored vests.
Armored vests. Man, these guys are heavy.
Had to aim at his head to bring him down.
Joe, you come upstairs with me and stick by Frank's new room with the other officer until we move Frank out.
All right.
Jerry, check hospital security to see how they got in.
Right.
I'll see you downstairs in 20 minutes.
Okay.
Come on in.
How's it going, Frank?
I guess I should be thanking you.
What for?
For saving my belly from 7 inches of steel.
Okay, look, there's no reason playing games with you. I think they're going to try again. That's why I'm having you moved.
Moved? Where?
To a small private hospital in Santa Mira. You'll go in under an assumed name and we'll issue a statement to the press that our only witness can't be any help to us.
Do you think that'll stop these guys from trying it again?
Who's ever behind this is going to have enough to worry about once we question our suspect. Well, how are you doing otherwise?
Oh, fine. It's a great life. Just move my little finger, will you? And they come running.
Okay. Get some sleep. They'll be moving in within a couple of hours. Look, I stopped by to talk to Ned yesterday. He wants you to come back to work at the bar once you get on your feet again. You interested?
Sure. Why not? One-handed bartender should be a great draw. Every bar should have at least one.
Well, if it isn't the dynamic duo, Lieutenant Forster and Mr. Farnham.
Doyle, I'll give you 1 second to get your ass out of my chair before I toss you and the chair right out the window.
What's the matter, Lieutenant? Crying the paperwork blues again?
Doyle, get your ass out of here. We've got work to do.
Hey, I'm just killing time until my suspect comes down for questioning. You know the guy they booked for attempted murder at the hospital?
What are you talking about?
Hey, here comes our baby now.
He's our baby.
Oh, no, not anymore. Hey, the captain's turned that questioning over to me. Seems you two have been delinquent at human relations course.
Huh? God damn it.
What's your bitch, Forrester?
Bring that jackass on our case.
Rating reports for the entire squad. Whole squad rates high. And now we come to Lieutenant Forrester.
Jesus Christ.
Reports and paperwork late and incomplete. Press relations. Smashed the TV camera. Deliberately.
Now that was...
Volunteer work, none. Favorable communications, 2 lousy letters. And last, but not least, attendance and performance in departmental training classes. You ranked last in the entire squad.
What about number of arrests? Number of convictions?
Sir, listen, Forrester. This damn stuff is just as important as the street work. That's what the commissioner looks at, like it or not.
Sir, we realize we missed that makeup class, but our key witness in the karate school murders...
Karate school murders? Karate... Oh, yes. Now I remember. I read about them in the newspaper somewhere. Because I still don't have your report.
Hell, we were out till 3 o'clock in the morning.
I don't give a damn how late you were out. You should have taken the time to at least jot down a lousy paragraph or two so that when the chief comes and questions me about it, I can halfway tell him something other than what I read in the newspapers. Forrester, you get your butt down to that human relations makeup session in half an hour. I've put Doyle and Rossi on the case, and you will fill them in, and you will cooperate with them. Is that clear, Lieutenant?
Yes, it's clear.
Now, I want a full report on your case, your former case, by quitting time this afternoon. Is that clear, Lieutenant?
Yes, clear, right.
Oh, and if you don't like my style, Forrester, you've got two choices. Turn in a transfer request or turn in your badge. I'll take either one. Otherwise, get on with the program.
Well, Forrester, we'll let you know how the case comes out. I hope you enjoy your class. Of course, I've already taken my class. Can't you tell by the way my personality's improved?
You want a briefing on the case?
No, I think I have all I need right now. Besides, I don't think your partner here is feeling any too cooperative today. All right, we got it. Go.
What good's this? He'll never talk.
He can listen. He can nod yes or no.
The recorder won't pick up the nods.
Well, then, Rossi, one of us is going to have to say suspect gestures yes or suspect gestures no. Are you all set?
Going to uncuff him?
Do what?
Oh, that's procedure. Kind of rough sitting there like that.
Are you crazy? You saw what those victims he hauled out of the karate school for...
All right. Want me to start the recorder?
Not yet. Wait a minute. I want this off the record. Now, I'm going to put this to you straight, buddy. Now, we've got you nailed for those murders at the karate school and that attempted murder at the hospital. Hmm? So now, if you cooperate with us, things will go a hell of a lot easier for you. All right, read him his rights.
They did that already when they booked it.
I want it on tape, Rossi.
All right. You have the right to remain silent. Anything you say can and will be used against you in a court of law. You have the right to talk to a lawyer and have him present while you are being questioned. If you cannot afford to hire a lawyer, one will be appointed to represent you before any questioning that you wish. If you decide at any time to exercise these rights and not answer any questions or make any statements. You understand? Something wrong with him. I think he's sick. I'm going to uncuff him.
Here, you want a glass of water?
Thank you.
Vehicle 331, suspect driving, dangerous, may be armed. Caucasian in black undershirt.
Go ahead and eat, son. Ma cooked it for you, no charge. You look like you've got trouble. Just remember, no matter what happens, put your trust in God, and He'll guide you to the right path. And I know it's hard to believe, especially when things are tough, but God looks out for all of us, whether we believe or not. Now, I've got some pamphlets here that you can have, and I want you to read them. They'll help you to find God. And if you ever need anyone to talk to, you can always come and see Ma and me. And if we're not open, we live in the back, and you can come look us up anytime. Anytime.
Yeah, a lot of beers and a cheeseburger.
What this place is, man! I don't want to eat here!
Shut up, asshole. We're eating here.
Hey, where's my beer? What is this?
All right. Don't mess with my hair, man. Don't do that.
Yeah?
Huh?
Howdy, friends and neighbors. This is Reverend L.J. Terhune.
And my weapon.
Shine on his glory from the inspired bankers.
Ooh. Hey, good looking. What are you doing today? You'd like to go for a little putt. Leave this dipshit you work, we'll go for a little ride. How about that?
And he put his hand on me.
That wouldn't mess up her hair, man.
That's okay. I'll take care of her hair.
Hey, you just sit down and be social.
Come on, boy. Leave my customers alone.
You just serve the beer, old man.
Oh, John, leave it brought alone. We have a problem here. Beer here. Hey. Who's the Tarzan guy? Hey, Tarzan. Running from the law, man? Hey, this guy's running from the law.
Hey, Tony, I smell pig, man. I think that dude's probably an undercover cop.
Yeah. Look at his haircut. Hey, he's gotta be a pig, man.
I don't know, man. Undercover cops, man, they got long hair. That dude's got short hair.
He's a turkey. That guy's a pig. Can't you smell it? Bad.
Hey. Are you a cop? Are you a cop?
Hey, I'm talking to you.
Talking to you. I'm talking to you, Tarzan. Talking to you. Shit, this guy is a cop. This guy's weird. Hey, don't you hear me talking to you? Don't you hear me talking to you? Talking to you, Tarzan. Hey, Tarzan. He's sitting there eating his cheeseburger. Tarzan. Look at the muscles on that guy, man. Yeah, with the blonde hair and everything. This guy's got to be running from the law. Look at that outfit. Hey. Hey, you. Talking to you. Tarzan. Listen. Look at this guy. Look at
Man, that guy's got some muscle. I got muscle. Mine are all on the inside, though. Hey, this guy's got blood on him. Hey, what's the matter with you, man? Hey, what? Hey, what we got here? Hey, man, you all on him.
Is brotherly love. So if you haven't sent for the 3D full-color portrait of the Holy Trinity, well, now's the time, because it's a picture so real to life, you can almost reach out and touch it. So if you send in $5.99 now, the 3D full-color portrait of the Holy Trinity plus the world's smallest Bible, both for only $5.99. Send check or money order to 3D, Box 422, Libby, California.
There's the devil.
Hey!
There's the devil. Oh, will you please get right down on your knees? Cause there's the devil by the door. Yes, there's the devil. Hey, now there's the devil. Hear what I say, just clap your hands.
Devil from the door.
And we all so will you please get back down on your knees? You hear what I say?
And shoo the devil from the door.
Hey, it's the devil standing by.
Look at there, it's the devil.
Perhaps we can continue with our work. Mr. Giolatti has suggested we try to persuade Nathan Adams to relinquish his position without resorting to violence.
You wish me to have a talk with him?
Yes, but before you do, I think we need some leverage.
Leverage?
He has a daughter.
Well, I'm fine, Daddy. I'm only 40 miles away. It's not like I'm on the other side of the world. Okay. Hey, look. If I don't finish my homework, I'll flunk out this semester. Can't you see the headlines? Bank president's daughter fails first semester of college. Shamed father jumps out window. No, I don't have any boys in the apartment. By the time I'm on the phone, I haven't had a chance to meet any. Okay. I love you, too. Bye.
Yes, Kay.
There's a Mr. Liu to see you. All right. Mr. Adams will see you now.
Thank you.
Oh, Mr. Liu, please, have a seat. Thank you. I'm sorry, but I must apologize. My secretary didn't tell me the nature of your business here.
I believe it was an ancestor of mine who once said, a picture speaks a thousand words.
The others in the photograph don't matter, but you do recognize your daughter. We do not want money. Everything will work out, and no harm will come to anyone.
Harm to no one? Putting my daughter through this?
She was not totally conscious at the time.
Get out of here. This cheap shakedown won't work.
You know, of course, that your financial colleagues will receive a set of these pictures.
I can explain it to them.
And will an explanation be sufficient? In your daughter's case, it might be a traumatic experience, a shame that might haunt her for the rest of her life. Even though your daughter may be as sexually sophisticated as other students today, I'm quite sure their sexual habits do not include this. Our clients wish you to resign your position and recommend this man.
What?
Sever your connections with this bank. You may then relocate to a different city and resume your career. That will fulfill your obligation. You will not be asked to do anything further.
Gioletti's behind this, isn't he?
That I'm sorry I cannot say. Merely, deliver your letter of resignation by noon today.
I'd be a fool to walk away from a job that's taken me my whole life to work up to. Just so a stooge can get into the bank? No.
In that case, Mr. Adams, please, move over to the filing cabinet. Move. I was hoping I did not have to resort to violence.
Get some help, please!
Now that the boss told me?
It's my lunch hour.
He said you used to use your lunch hours to study.
Well, I quit school.
Why? I thought you had dreams of becoming an architect.
Yeah.
Did you get the cards I sent down to the Santa Mira Hospital? I tried to come down to see how you were doing, but well, my schedule's been pretty rough lately. Nights, mostly. I have a few days off now.
Thanks for coming over. I'll see you.
Don't worry. I found my way in by myself.
Look, I'm sorry.
I'm the one who's sorry for getting involved.
You don't know how it is for me.
I know how it is, Frank.
No one asked you to go and...
to get involved? Sure. No one did. Look, I won't be bothering you anymore. Goodbye, Frank. Aren't you even going to call me back?
I wasn't thinking about it.
I can see it's going to take some time getting used to you.
Why would you even want to try?
I don't know. Maybe by the time I get used to you, you'll be used to yourself.
Would you like to come over to the bar for some coffee? Maybe the waiter isn't too friendly, but the coffee's pretty good.
Is it a nice bar?
I've seen better entertainment in a zoo.
Living in a monkey house, I'll bet you have.
Sorry to leave you alone. I had to get those cases moved.
That's all right. I was just watching the entertainment.
Oh, yeah. Ned just hired her last week. He thought it helped business, only it hasn't.
Do you like working here?
The hours were flexible enough, which helped when I was in college. The pay's fair.
What are your plans now that you've quit school?
I don't know. I just don't know yet. I need time to think.
Frank, you got any change for the jukebox?
Not now, Sharon.
All right, Frank. Does she always ask you for change?
Oh, that's just her way of getting tips.
Frank, will you get me another case of beer from the back?
Huh? Yeah, sure, Ned.
So that was you who called on the phone, huh? Well, I see you found him all right.
Oh, yeah. He was down at the karate school, just like you said.
I don't know what's gotten into him. He's been there every day this week.
He's
just trying to find himself.
Well, it's a terrible thing that happened to him, but he shouldn't be wasting his time in a closed-down karate school.
He'll be all right.
And don't you give up on him. No matter how nasty he gets, if you can't bring him around, nobody can.
Maybe your dancer can.
Oh, I worry about her.
Hey, give me a beer.
All right. All right. Hit it easy.
Hey! Come on now.
Knock it off! Knock it off!
All right, I'll give you your money back. Let it alone. I want the buck for the beer back, too. It stinks!
Why don't you shut the hell up?
What are you? Knock it off! Yeah.
Now?
I don't know.
I mean, where do we go from here?
Well, I guess I go back to the bar and you go back...
Back to the hospital.
I'm sorry, I didn't mean it that way. Maybe we should both go back to the hospital and start all over again.
I wish we could go back in time.
I'd like to go back a lot farther than that. When those three guys came crashing through that window.
If only I'd gotten one of them.
Trade a life for a hand?
Yes. I feel a lot better about this now.
Look, you should get away from here for a while. Get away from this apartment, away from the karate studio, away from the bar, from everything. Just for a little while.
You said you had a few days off from the hospital.
3 days.
Well, maybe we could drive out to the ocean for a couple of days. I got enough money for food, gas, a movie or two, and a motel.
Is it a nice motel?
Mm-hmm.
Our employer, Mr. Giolelli, is arriving at his airfield in 1 hour. He's bringing the balance of the money.
Shall we give him the usual receipt?
But of course, he's not powerful enough to change our method of doing business.
I'll take care of him myself.
You had better take help. Mr. Giolelli may have the same idea about us.
It shall be done.
CWJ. 605 CWJ.
Get out and call the police department. Homicide. Ask for Lieutenant Forrester. Tell him what's happening.
What are you going to do?
Just get out before I lose them.
You can't go after them.
I'm just going to follow them. Get out.
But Frank.
Get out.
Homicide. Oh, yes. What can I do for you?
We just found the three men who killed the people in the karate studio.
You found them? No, just calm down. Did you get the license number? Where are you now? Stay there. I'll put a tracer on the license number.
Frank's following them now. I don't know what he's going to do.
Just stay there.
Put a tracer out on this. Meet me in a car and tell them the radio has the information.
Where the hell are you going? I want that report.
Look, the three suspect in the karate school murders have just been cited. I have a chance to pick up all three of them, including the one that Doyle let escape and tear up the department. So to hell with the report, to hell with the paperwork, and screw you. Forrester? Forrester?
Thank you.
Thank you. Flight 983 leaves at gate 4 in half an hour. Enjoy your flight.